How watching porn disrupts your ability to think, and more importantly, what to do about it. I'm Dr. Trish Lee. I'm here to tell you how to think better if you're still watching porn, and especially if you are rebooting your brain so that you can feel and perform better. Okay, in this video, we are first going to talk about a study by Reed et al. And the impact that pornography consumption has on executive function skills. I'm going to tell you what those are, and I'm going to tell you the most common skills that are disrupted by a pornography habit. Then I'm going to share with you what you can do to bring those very specific skills back online in your brain tip at the end of this video. Okay, so this study used a behavioral analysis, and it's called the BRIEF. And I'm going to check my notes so that I don't mess up what I'm telling you here. It's called the Behavior Rating Inventory of Executive Function, the BRIEF A, because it's for adults. Now, the areas of need that were found to be most disrupted in people who have a compulsive hypersexual behavior, which we know from the science, watching pornography is the number one way that compulsive hypersexuality plays out. So it means people who watch porn, for the most part. How this shows up is there's a disruption in executive function. So executive function is the thinking skills that come from the prefrontal cortex in your brain. Up here in the front is a whole host of thinking skills that allow you to be able to plan, to be able to follow through, to be able to do all the small steps in a big project, to be able to remember. So the skills that were most found to be disrupted are being able to shift, cognitive flexibility, and being able to shift between tasks in problem solving. So being able to think back and forth, cognitive flexibility, and being able to kind of shift ideas and have flexible thinking, not rigid thoughts, and also being able to transition between different types of thinking or different topics or different thought processes. So number one is shift. Shifting was found to be disrupted, poorer skills if you watch porn. And I'm gonna tell you what to do about it in a few minutes. Okay, the second is emotional control. Being able to modulate or to control your own emotional responses. We're gonna talk about this in a minute. To be able to initiate, being able to independently begin a task or generate ideas or responses or problem solving strategies. Being able to initiate your own thoughts and to be able to solve a problem. That one's gonna come online as you leave the habit behind. I find that that is the most difficult skill for people if they still are sucked in by a pornography habit. If the hijacker has his hands on the wheels and the wheel, the steering wheel, and he's driving the car, you're in the passenger seat. It's very difficult to initiate thoughts in your own life, but we'll talk about it. And then lastly is to plan and organize to manage your current and future-oriented task demands. So these are all executive function skills that are disrupted. Now, what this study shows, which is actually really cool, I think, is that when these skills are improved, that helps to be able to avoid the urges and the cravings that you experience. Now, the reason being is many times the sexual compulsivity or the need to go back to sexual behaviors that manifests in urges and cravings is what keeps these skills from developing and being able to be used well. So the good news is that as these skills develop, cravings and urges go away. And like I've shared with you, I am so proud of this awesome new program that I am putting together, and having an executive function project that you work on, and I'm going to tell you just how to do it in the program, but an executive function project that you're working on to bring all these skills online can be, again, just one of the number one ways that you can get your thinking moving in the right direction. Okay, so before we talk about four strategies for each one of those types of thinking skills, I want to share one more finding from the study. It says that another major thing that you can learn how to do that will help all of this come online is to learn how to deal with uncomfortable and stressful situations. So a finding that came out of this study is that not being able to deal with the discomfort that I talk about, the pain inside that you have from the past or from the present, the drudgery of the present that so many people tell me about, not being on purpose in your life, not being able to deal with those uncomfortable and stressful situations is what makes you run back to the habit to get that dopamine release to feel okay. Being able to confront and to be able to move towards solution of those situations in your life helps you to be able to approach, it's called approach, to be able to approach those situations, which will help you to bring these executive function skills online. So all of this works together is what I'm telling you. It's very synergistic. Okay, so there's one more finding, then I'll give you the brain tip. One more finding, a new finding, is that working memory is impaired as well. And there's multiple other studies, and there's actually many new studies that show, especially in younger people, that working memory is impaired because working memory exists right here up in the prefrontal cortex. Working memory is holding information in your memory so that you can work with it while you are working on other thinking tasks. And if your brain is being bogged down by hypofrontality, which is too much use of that slow speed that I'm telling you about consistently, if your brain's using too much of that slow speed and then it's offsetting it by too much of the extra fast speed, it is not processing in real time all of the thinking that you need to do to be able to reach your full potential. So the solution is to leave the habit behind. Your brain will start to heal itself and rewire itself to use more of that perfect processing speed, which will allow you to practice the skills in these executive function tasks. Okay, so shifting. You have to practice shifting between the tasks. The takeaway for the brain tip today, number two, the brain tip. The takeaway is you have to actually practice the exact thinking skill to get better at it. So you might have seen in like pop science where they tell people to do Sudoku, which actually I don't even know how to play Sudoku because I've never done it, or do crossword puzzles. Crossword puzzles are going to make you better at coming up with the word for a description because that's what the thinking skill that crossword puzzles enhances. So as you try to get better at these four skills, you need to practice these very specific four skills that science shows us are impaired in most people. Shifting. Practice shifting between multiple topics without getting stressed out. Practice transitioning from one thinking task to another without having to escape. And do it in small chunks. It's called scaffolding. Set yourself up for success by doing a little bit of this, not a lot of bit of this at one time. Because remember, you want to do a little, be successful, celebrate it. That's a small win. We're going to hardwire in these new, better executive function skills. Okay, number two, emotional control. The tip that I have for you on this one is to take a breath and walk away before you react. You are learning to respond in emotional situations, not react to them. Respond within them, not react to them. Reacting to them is spitting off exactly what you think in that very moment before you actually think about it. We know this is an impaired skill, so you need to practice. Have emotional control. Go take three breaths. Think about what you want to say and respond, and then do it. Okay, initiate. You're going to have to force yourself to initiate a new task. Problem solve something, do it for a little bit. Initiate so that you can practice getting a new task going, generating a new idea, problem solving something. Try, do it, force yourself. You'll get better and better over time. Lastly, planning and organizing, managing your current and future oriented tasks. Again, plan something. Organize something, set yourself up for success, and practice that skill so you can get better at it. But practice the exact skill that you are struggling with. If it's not this one, then practice the one that you are struggling with. If it's working memory, read an article, hold some of the information in your memory for a little while, Go wash some dishes, come back, and write about that article. You held that information in your mind for a few minutes so that you could work with it. You can come back and write about it or draw about it. Hold that information in memory if you're practicing working memory. Okay, hope those strategies help you so you can get your thinking back online, get your executive function cranking so that you can create a project that feels great in your life, get on purpose, use your mind, use your body, reach your full potential. Leave the habit behind because it's dragging your thinking down. If you want help in that journey, I'm here for you. I would absolutely love to help you. Go over to my website at drtrishlee.com. I have new programs coming soon, and I am here to help you. I am down for the work. As always, remember, control your brain or it'll control you.